We will now move to our media perspectives on linguistic diversity. So I'd like to welcome Gustavo Arellano from the OC Weekly to come speak.
Hello, welcome, hola, and all those other languages, all of you may speak. Thank you for inviting me here. I know I don't have a fancy degree. I'm just a reporter for a free newspaper that gets our income via escort ads and marijuana ads. But I think I can tell you folks a little bit about the perspective on linguistic diversity that the media has. And the perspective is this, basically. I'll make the claim, the very bold claim, that my profession is among the most stubbornly, stupidly monolinguistic professions in the world, which is mainstream media. And you could take this model anywhere across the world, in the mainstream media. Of course, I'll limit my comments to the American mainstream media. And by mainstream media, I mean those daily newspapers published in the dominant language in a particular country. By mainstream media, I mean those papers published by multi-million-dollar corporations, by big families with a lot of money. Here used to be the Chandlers in Washington D.C., the Grahams, the Sulzbergers, of course, with the New York Times and the like. We are a profession that hates linguistic diversity. We are a profession that will never, ever, in a million years, try to court the other, try to even acknowledge that we have other languages being spoken amongst us. It is something that is, you know, pardon the pun, but it's something that is foreign to us, this idea that anybody could even bother to speak in a language other than English in this country. And it is a profession that those very few times that we do use foreign words, it's almost always acceptable foreign words from our European languages. From our European languages. It's a profession that we will never use words from foreign tongues unless we explain exactly what it is, and it's therefore ruined the whole idea of trying to apply those languages to our writings and to try to make our readers appreciate a little bit more of what we do. And it is a language, it is a profession that in my case, in the case of Spanish, and specifically in the case of Mexican Spanish, the few times Mexican Spanish does get used by the American media, it is always in a mocking way. It is always in some way to degrade Mexicans, to degrade immigration, and it's very, very, very loaded. So as a result of that, I will also make another very bold claim. I will make a bold claim that I write a column, which I'll talk about in a bit, but that my column is the most magnificently mangled linguistically speaking, column in the United States. My column is a column that makes no linguistic sense whatsoever, and it is done specifically for that purpose. Because I despise my profession, how enamored we are of English, I make it my point as a writer, as a reporter, to just throw as many linguistic monkey wrenches to my readers as possible, come hell or high water. That's my opening remark. Let me now tell you folks who I am, and I also apologize for the next 2 minutes of shameless self-promotion, but as a reporter, we always have to plug who we are because we never know who we might have an audience again, so bear with me. My name is Gustavo Arellano. I am a staff writer for a newspaper called the OC Weekly. We're based in Orange County, California, just down the 405 freeway. The OC Weekly, it is a free newspaper. It comes out every week, hence the weekly. You can find us online at ocweekly.com. I do three distinct things for the paper. The most important job by far, I'm the food editor for the paper. So if for whatever reason God condemns you to go down to Orange County, because we're not a very nice place, you can email me. I know all the great restaurants. I've been doing that job for almost 10 years now. I'm also an investigative reporter. As an investigative reporter, I do a lot of investigations into corruption. As a sole minority reporter for my paper, I'm also the minority reporter, so I cover all the different various beats of the different ethnic groups that we have in Orange County. At alternate times in my time at the OC Weekly, I've been called Orange County's best Muslim reporter. I'm not Muslim. Because no one bothers covering the Muslim Arabic community in Orange County seriously. Same thing with Vietnamese reporter. I'm not Vietnamese. And the various other communities that we do have. What gets me the most notoriety, though, is a column called Ask a Mexican that I write for the OC Weekly. It's distributed nationally. It's in, I think, 38 newspapers across the country. And Ask a Mexican is exactly what it sounds like. People send me questions about Mexicans, and I answer them. And it doesn't matter what the questions may be. They could be racist questions, they could be sexist questions, they could be serious questions, they could be questions about history, they could be questions about my personal favorite topic, etymology, which is one of the reasons why I was so excited to, and honored to be invited here, linguistics, midgets, whatever you may imagine, I answer them. And the very specific purpose of the column for me is to debunk and destroy those stereotypes and misconceptions that people have specifically about Mexicans, not Latinos, not Hispanics, specifically about the Mexican in American culture, which it, that's why it also incorporates Mexican-American, Chicano, and all the different, anything that America imagines to be a Mexican, that's what I deal with in my column. And the reason I do that column, it's a very personal reason. I am the child of immigrants. My parents are Mexicans from the state of Zacatecas. Anybody from Zacatecas here? I always have to ask that, especially in Los Angeles. Zacatecas is a state in central Mexico that is probably most famous in academic circles for its hometown benefit associations. In other words, all the immigrants that have come up from Zacatecas to the United States, we send more money back in remittances than any other state in Mexico. And here in Southern California, there's hundreds of thousands of us. For those of us in Southern California, the way I describe Zacatecanos is that we're the modern-day Iowans of Southern California. In other words, we're a community that has migrated en masse to here, and within our own sphere, we're known for those sort of homespun values, and instead of having picnics in Long Beach once a year, we have humongous baseball tournaments with our preferred form of music, which is basically a variation of umpa music called tamborazo. So that was the society that I grew up in. My first language was Spanish. I did not speak a lick of English until I entered kindergarten. I asked my mom, how did I learn English? And she told me that she didn't enroll me in bilingual education because she wanted me to learn English as fast as possible. I don't know if that really worked. I know that I probably by first grade, I would speak English and Spanish equally. By second grade, and ever since, English has been my primary language. So as a result, I still can speak Spanish fluently. My parents would say I speak it like a pocho, in other words, like an assimilated Mexican-American, which is to say not very good, but I can speak it.